What's up, ladies and gentlemen? We are here for the BigPoint battle. This time around, it's the round of 8. We have eL'Pride going up against Typical Mistakes with a new lineup. Not a really new lineup, but simply a little bit of a switch, I believe. Because I don't recognize this guy, Slizel, here. But maybe I will find out soon. Fan of Soyon, he was the guy that was captaining all the times that I was casting Typical Mistakes in the past, so I'm interested to see how well they will fare up against Mini. A relatively star-studded lineup so far. I mean, they got Mini, they got Link. Mini, former team captain of the Cube, had Red Pandas. Hestejoy and Noya, they're from 3D Max. I think Crit might have been on that squad as well, not so sure, but a very, very strong mix of well-known names out of the competitive Dota 2 scene. So, if you guys are tuning in right now, whether it be at the live stream or the VOD on YouTube, I want to thank you guys for doing so. So happy to have you here. With me today will be eL'Prez as a co-caster. Hello, good sir. How are you doing?
I am doing incredibly well.
Yeah, that's great. That's good. Maybe some of that might be due to the fact that we're casting some good dotes.
Yeah, I got to cast Typical Mistakes earlier this week for the Dota 2 Canada Cup, and they actually had a very impressive showing, and this was their lineup there, so I'm not familiar with their former lineup.
Okay, I also, to be honest, I'm not exactly sure who the fourth... I just don't remember seeing Slizel on their lineup before that, so... but
yeah, they're very solid. They're actually top four right now. They made it to the round of four against Arctic, Root Gaming, and X-Fnatic NA, so...
Yeah, they are very strong. I mean, I'm very impressed with the way they play. It seems very experienced and just skilled. Their team movement has always been very nice. And I mean, they're going to need that against eL'Pride, that's for sure. We're in the round of eight. So the winner of this best of one advances into the quarterfinals, which we're also going to be doing after that. Perhaps you will have time to stick around for that as well, because I did book you for that as well. So if you would like to, then I can have you around for that as well. But we'll see. Later on. Let's catch up with the draft though quickly. The first two picks have been done. Typical Mistakes pick up Visage, a hero we have seen in every single game so far. Just such a strong trial lane support, just one of the strongest supports out there. Lone Dude also not to be messed with. Nature's Prophet on the other hand, also for eL'Pride, an extremely nuisant hero with strong farming capabilities and able to make a plus one out of any situation. And of course a Gyrocopter, a very well known hard carry.
Yeah, so far both sides are drafting really solid. Typical Mistakes definitely looking at trying to make a more aggressive tri-lane coming out with that Visage pickup. That said, with the OD ban, they also kind of want to make a very safe mid lane for Ryu, because otherwise he's going to have some issues for the most part if he plays any int mid. So I'm feeling Typical Mistakes might be picking up a Queen of Pain, because that did manage to get through. And that would leave another support. eL'Pride still have the Shadow Demon option though, which I'm very surprised got through this far.
Yeah, definitely. And I mean, Shadow Demon versus Visage is definitely a strong hero to have. Disruption is worth so much in reaction and initiation. In so many situations, a Disruption is such a great skill to have. So I would be surprised if they don't go for that, because I mean, it's in the pool, it might not be in the pool for much longer, and they need the support.
Yeah, and of course, if they do decide to pass up the Shadow Demon, I would expect a Bane pick at the very least, which does function quite well against Lone Druid as well. So, it's hard to say. I'm not sure which one is really, really more significant for eL'Pride to really have right now, the Shadow Demon or the Bane. Obviously, you really don't want to have both. That's kind of overdoing it on the slight early game defensive side. There's not a lot of damage if you have those two as your supports.
Yeah, that's correct. That is correct. Visage is just a hero that forces you to make a decision. You know, do you want to go and fight them, or do you want to try and avoid them, pick a safe solo lane and try to pressure the other lanes and force a reaction out? But in most cases, fighting against the Visage becomes very tricky. And I mean, we see a Windrunner pick out of eL'Pride. Do you think this could be a support Windrunner?
It's hard to say. Mostly because it is so early in eL'Pride's draft, Windrunner is just so flexible like that. It's very possible that Windrunner could go mid or off lane, as well as Nature's Prophet. That's the kind of flexibility eL'Pride lineup have right now. They basically have three heroes, all of which have been known to solo, off lane, and mid, basically. So it's hard to say what eL'Pride is really looking at doing right now.
Mm-hmm. So it appears to me that they're doing a pretty good job drafting so far. I mean, it's very important I mean, if you are able to draft in a way where you're very hard to read, it's definitely a route that you would like to take with you. And actually a standing pick by Typical Mistakes. He's also a hero that, you know, it's not unheard of to see him in mid, but obviously most of the time we see him run as a support. I wonder though, I mean, Visage with her slow would be able to give Sand King the positional advantage that he might need to get that burst strike in, even though on level 1 it's really ridiculously low ranged. But what do you think of this? I mean, they get another reliable disable, an AoE disable, even if he gets it coupled off right. And,
I have a couple issues with Sand King as a hero. That said, I know he... Okay, everything about Sand King has stopped for a moment. I love Crystal Maiden. I think she's a really, really good support hero. I don't know if it really fits within Lion's Pride's lineup, and especially against Typical Mistakes, if Crystal Maiden's caught out, she is gone.
Super dead. She's like 10 times dead.
Yeah, with 280 movement speed, she is not going to be able to run away from Visage with Grave Chill on her, and the Burrow Strike will land, and that's a very dead Crystal Maiden. Don't know exactly what Lion's Pride is planning to do with it, mostly because as nice as the mana is, the mana aura, Nature's Prophet won't need it, and Gyrocopter might, but usually he builds things like Ring of Aquila anyways, so it's hard to say.
Yeah, so maybe they aren't really taking CM because of the aura, but more so because of her skirmishing abilities. I mean, granted, she's extremely squishy, and whoever plays that CM will need to be a boss when it comes to positioning, but she does pack quite a punch if she gets that experience.
Yeah, I completely agree. She's probably one of the best roaming heroes in the game, and she had a higher base movement speed. I wouldn't be surprised to see her go from, like, 4th-tier pick to 2nd or 3rd-tier pick. Mostly because her abilities are so strong. She has a very powerful slow on a very moderate cooldown that lasts a fairly long period of time. But really, that Frostbite ability is such a strong early game disable. At 3 seconds, it doesn't do a lot of damage. That's all true, but it's only a 10-second cooldown with a 3-second disable. So it's still a very powerful ability in tandem with Crystal Nova. Alright, so it is a support winner.
Yeah, and we see TA one more time, so... It appears to me that we're going to be seeing most likely an either long lane abandoning Nature's Prophet or long laning NP with TA mid and then a defensive or... Well, it might be also be an offensive trial lane. Who knows? It's going to be rough to say. But who was it? One of the big teams ran Windrunner as a support not more than like 2 weeks ago.
Usually Mao's that does that with Cinderin on Windrunner.
And it worked out really well. Like, it was awesome. And the thing is, it's so counterintuitive to see Windrunner as a support because it's a hero that is so utterly dependent on experience. And it's like a high-risk, high-reward kind of support because if you end up with an under-leveled Windrunner, she is gonna be trouble for you, for your own team, because she won't be able to contribute nearly as much to the fights, to these little skirmishes that will be erupting. And holy crap! I didn't even realize that Lifestealer made it all the way toward the last pick phase.
This is going to be really troublesome for Lion's Pride. I do believe that Lifestealer, his feast, does 2 instances of damage separately, so it will burn through and refraction a little bit quicker. I have to check that in a little bit. So Typical Mistakes, I think, actually has a stronger draft out of this, especially if they want to go aggressive with this.
Okay, you can keep on analyzing because I just am switching the overlays.
Alright, so further analysis, eL'Pride are definitely looking, trying to make a early gank onto Ryu into mid, because if they don't get him killed early, he's going to snowball very, very heavily, especially against heroes like Nature's Prophet. Noya's going to be often going to be by himself, caught out, and if he is by himself, that's when Storm Spirit really is at his strongest. He just kind of electric balls in, does the electric vortex, and kind of just blows up any solo hero very quickly. Especially.
Sorry, I was just going to ask, do you mean snowball or electric ball?
You know, I feel really bad. The other day I said I want to play Storm Spirit so I can ball out of control, and that was completely on accident. But, no, seriously.
And everybody's like, what are you doing? I got that.
He is such a good hero. I'm surprised he sees less play than he does as a popular solo mid. He does have that, you know, extreme ganking weakness in early game engagements until he hits that level 6. But once he hits 6, he's almost impossible to kill. And he does so much. He has a ton of regen varied onto him. He is He has a bunch of regen.
He is a beggar. He is one of the worst kinds of people. He spends all of his gold to get those stats, bonus items, last hit damage, lane dominance, and then after he spent all of his gold, he goes to his team and says, "Hey, come on, man. Give me some consumables." And I'm a Sheep gives him some, Slizel gives him some, so you should never give in to people like this. But at least when he hits the lane, he hits for 61, and he has a crapload of restoratives, and I think he needs it against a TA too. She's going for a bottle rush, but even with refraction, she's still going to hit probably as hard. Now, let's get caught up here very quickly. The Spirit Bear is extremely low on life due to that DD rune on Crit, who is playing Windrunner, but it survives and gets that creep wave safely to Lone Druid for slaughter. So
It's running back.
Oh, it's that little choke point here. That is always so troublesome for the creep wave.
It lost line of sight and it's running back. Mm-hmm. That's really bad.
Alright, so let's quickly go over our lineups here. Linky's playing Gyrocopter over on the Radiant side for eL'Pride. We got Mini on the support Crystal Maiden. Crit, support Windrunner. Hestajo, Rotten. He's playing Templar Assassin in the solo mid. And long lane, we got Noya playing Nature's Prophet.
On Typical Mistakes, we're going to see Cakes abandoning lane and go into the jungle with Lone Druid. Solo mid will be Ryu on that Storm Spirit. On the support duo, it's I'm a Sheep Sucks on Visage. Slicel taking that Sand King. And Fana Soyan will be taking Lifestealer into this carry role.
Yeah, so I mean, Nature's Prophet. The thing is as soon as... what I'm trying to get at is we have one long lane solo abandoning and we have one long lane solo laning, and both of them would have been up against the defensive tri-lane. So what do you think is the better decision here?
I actually have no idea what Cakes is up to anymore. He's like, oh no, he's going back down there. He's like dancing around and running around in circles and he left his bear. I have no idea what's going on with Cakes.
I mean, on one side, Nature's Prophet, you know, he is able to kind of get a little bit of experience or pull those creeps with his Treants. On the other side, he's living extremely dangerously. Cakes now doing the same thing, as he said, but there's already a rotation from Crit. He's on level 2, and he has 1 point in Shackle Shot, and he's keeping the other point ready to spend it when kind of the demand for it arises.
So, yeah, level 1 Power Shot isn't exactly the strongest ability ever, so I'm not surprised. Definitely Windrun is one of the better abilities when it comes to, you know, actually just fighting. So, I really, really hope that eL'Pride try to make some sort of movement onto Ryu into mid before it's too late. If Ryu hits level 6, their window to actually get a kill on this guy is going to be completely demolished, and Hestajo, with the current skill build that he has, should be fine. Honestly, to just put up enough damage and make a mid gank happen. Yeah, I have no idea what Cakes is doing. He just had to resummon his bear because he's trying to tank Ancients at level 2.
Yeah, not all too effective. Although he did manage to almost hit level 3, sitting at 2, just on the edge of level 3, about to hit it. He's focusing that big guy as well. So farming the Ancients here a little bit. Slizel, level 1.5, sitting at the enemy secret shop. Noya, 7-0, level 3, has been hit. He is sitting in the river and farming the creeps. Slizel now coming back down, blocks him a little bit with his body, looking for that stun. I don't think that is going to be enough for that slow from Sheep, but he might be proving me wrong. Yes, there's that slow. Is there going to be another disable? I doubt it. Noya TP's back into safety, and that lost Typical Mistakes a lot of experience on lane, and Nature's Prophet just spends 135 gold and TP's back to lane where there's a triple, 2.5 creep waves moving his way.
Yeah, definitely poor movement coming out of Typical Mistakes. They weren't really able to get the position fast enough to take him out, and that's actually going to be a huge problem. I feel like they should have been punishing Noya more because he is a Nature's Prophet. He's actually very easy to kill in lane. So, I'm shocked, but there's actually going to be a huge rotation coming in. Well, small rotation coming out of Hestajo right now.
Yeah, Haste Rune is ready for him as well, but Typical Mistakes are backing out for now. If we look at the last hits here very quickly, we have Gyrocopter sitting at 24-4. Make that 26, or maybe even 27. 21 on TA, 21 on Nakes, and 21 on Stone Spirit. So, the middle lane is extremely even so far, and if they go undisturbed in terms of farming both of them, then they will have their separate instances of game impact. And I gotta say, Storm Spirit has a lot more game impact early on, as he has that built-in mobility spell, whereas Hestijo on TA will need to farm up a Blink Dagger, and that's just a, you know, once in a team fight most of the time ability that he's going to use for the initiation, whereas Storm Spirit will be able to pressure and help his teammates out a lot sooner. But then again, it comes down to the question, does Storm Spirit rotate off his mid lane when he hits level 6? You know, there's some people that do it this way, and there's some that do it other.
I do think Kanitz will probably rotate out and get some kills onto the Nature's proc early. With that said, sitting in lane just to farm a faster Orchid wouldn't be a bad option either at this point. Especially against eL'Pride's lineup, if you really can't get some additional kind of silences or stuns onto Nature's Prophet, it's going to be very difficult to keep him down. Mm-hmm. And you also want that for the Gyrocopter in 1v1 trades, because otherwise you're going to get caught by the Rocket Barrage and you will die very, very easily that way. And the timing window for eL'Pride has fallen. Ryu hits level 6, gets his bottle, so it's going to be very hard to kill him now.
Yeah, Sonic Spirit will be very rough to kill. It appears that both teams are just very happy to do what they feel is the most important thing to do in this match. I mean, there's a tier 2 tower going down 6 minutes into the game, so the bottom lane completely pushed out in favor of eL'Pride. Both towers gone, a lot of gold going the way of eL'Pride. Whereas, of course, Ryu in mid happy to be hitting level 6, whereas Hestijo, though, he's at almost level 7. So he's out leveling Sonic Spirit a little bit, who's out last hitting TA. And they're just still playing their game. So bottom lane completely abandoned by TM. And the top tier 1 taking some punishment as well. There's a hand of Midas completed up on Nakes. But I don't even know if they will be able to get that tower pushed by now, because we have Crit as well as Noya here to try and take the creep aggro off the tier 1 tower. Slyzel very low on life, and he now has mana for his stun, but the tier 1 tower is still standing. Now there's a TP in by Hestijo. The ulti will be ready in just a few seconds. He will be able to slow down heroes that, well, they're not Nakes. But yeah, no target found here.
I'm surprised that she wasn't able to get any closer, because Phantasialion has no boots. That was just kind of weird.
Yeah, Nakes has a pretty high movement speed, I guess.
Yeah, he's actually, I think, one of the fastest heroes at 315, and like the actual fastest is Luna at like 330 or something like that. Something ridiculous like that. Mm-hmm. Oh, Hestijo. Are they going to go on him? Slyzel.
Yeah, there was a nice waiting here by him. In the meantime, enemy Ancients, we got Lone Druid dropping. That's the first blood going the way of eL'Pride. And that is the kind of opening that you get if you push down the two towers on bottom lane. Couple that off with a very nice Observer Ward as placed down here. You get free kills if an enemy strays too far into the enemy Ancients, or into his own Ancients.
Yeah, and then we also saw that Nature's Prophet, Noya, was able to just TP in and really help out that whole engagement. So, you know, real advantage Nature's Prophet, you're always the plus one. So when you're doing these early trades, you really got to be keeping Nature's Prophet down so he can't contribute to any of these fights. He is actually still working towards a Midas, it looks like. So, it's a bit late for that.
Mm-hmm. Now the top tier 1, still not being given up by eL'Pride. There's the rotations coming in, CM also showing up, but they're committing to this. TM, they want to get this. There's the slow, there's a TP by NP as well. Is it going to be denied? Yes, Nature's Prophet gets it. They get a kill on Sand King, and there's an infest by Nakes into one of the enemy creeps. So they have two kills up onto Book of Mistakes, they have two towers up, and they deny their own tier 1. Everything is going the way of eL'Pride so far. So TM, they need that Storm Spirit to have impact on the game ASAP.
Yeah,
Hestijo, mid lane in trouble. There's that stun. Right click's coming in, and that's the first kill for the Pokemon Stakes.
Cooldown was dropped. Didn't actually really hit much. It hit Slyzel on the back end, but that's not the most significant thing ever. They do spot a Sentry Ward and take it out, so that's actually a pretty big deal. It's going to make it a little bit safer for Hestijo to stay in this lane a little bit more now. Less concerned. And they're also going to be able to find this ward when they go up to high ground, so they're going to be kicking that out. Link!
Oh, middle lane, yep. Link being attacked a little bit. And there's another thing, though. Storm Spirit, you know, even though he's level 6, the mana pool is still very much constraining him. And he needs more intelligence, more mana, to be able to just, you know, do what Storm Spirit does best. You know, just balling around the team fight, having impact. Right now he's sitting on almost no mana. And yeah, he backs out, goes back to base, yep. He realizes he doesn't have any impact.
I think the biggest problem with Storm Spirit, though, is that when you get more mana, as a, like, your mana pool gets larger, your Electric Ball starts costing more relative to your pool, so it becomes a real pain to kind of support your mana pool. So that's generally why you see items that have some int, but then a lot of mana regen, things like Orchid, and then occasionally you'll also see Bloodstones getting picked up as well. But Bloodstones, not the best item anymore. Oh, okay, how did that happen?
Visage mid lane, kind of out of position. Try to TP out, but the physical DPS was still there. So it's a 3-1 so far for eL'Pride. Looking good, man, looking good. Tier 1 tower also down. Let's have a look at the gold graph here very quickly. But yeah, to get back to your point there about Sorcerer, definitely. I mean, the Ball Lightning is a very expensive one, and it stays, you know, as expensive throughout all stages of the game. So mana regen, definitely a nice factor to have. The overall mana pool obviously does contribute toward, you know, the amount of times you're able to use your other two skills. And
They're doing an Ace Bomb.
Top TP coming in. Noya might be in some big trouble here.
You gotta get closer though. Oh, that's too far away. You're not gonna have any mana.
Yeah, but he wants Nakes to do what he does best, and he doesn't have that. Oh, Noya. Oh, he had his TP was on cooldown. Okay. He threw out his ultimate, threw it on everything he could, but still he drops after all. So Ryu, if essentially just functioning as a taxi cab there. Sanking drops on bottom to Link. Sorry, go ahead.
No, I was about to say, it's like I was really concerned. I thought Noya had his TP up. And when I saw Ryu just electric ball from there to here, I thought he was going to be he was completely out of mana to use an electric vortex. So, had Noya had the TP, he probably would have been able to get up fine. Because Phantasoyun's damage right now isn't really anything spectacular. So, it's okay. 89 damage isn't bad. But with only one level of Feast and not the best attack speed, he's not really getting a lot done.
Yeah, true that. But speaking of getting things done, eL'Pride is getting things done, man. They pushed down three towers already. Now they're working on the last tier 1 on the map. That will be the top. And there's no signs of a struggle being shown by Typical Mistakes. eL'Pride is kind of having their way. And the thing is, what can Typical Mistakes do about this? I mean, the gold graph is slowly but steadily really working its way into eL'Pride's side. It's already about 4k and 5k now after this tier 1. And they're not stopping. They want to continue fighting. Now, Typical Mistakes, they want to challenge it. They want to fight. But, I mean, look at Sand King, level 5.5. Nakes, level 9, about to level 10. He's looking good. Lone Druid, 8.5. But look at that. They don't have those big teamfight ultimates. eL'Pride, they are just completely... I don't know, man. It looks like they're out-strategizing the enemy because they don't have what it takes to fight back just yet.
I completely agree. It was a part strategy, but I think a lot of...
Oh, we're going to have to wait, my friend. The team fight's starting. Ryu jumps himself in there. Now he's out of mana. So this is that little mana pool we're talking about. I'm a sheep. Very low in life, actually. Hestro getting focused now as well. Turns out to fight this. I'm a sheep manning up and getting the kill on TA. In the meantime, Slyzel also in very low life, just backing out and surviving. So what a defense by Typical Mistakes.
A little bit of mistake by Hesed Joe. I guess he didn't notice that they dropped the sentry, which I don't blame him for that. But he ended up going invis right here, right inside of this new sentry range. I think that's about like 600 units. So it was he was actually like just inside of the range. And I say just inside because this trap isn't being spotted.
Oh, okay.
And he's like right there.
Well, maybe you just didn't want to be unfair. I want to be a sportsman.
Exactly, and he probably could have gotten away, he wouldn't have, unless these are brand new sentries. I have no idea anymore. Usually sentries and wards show up on these items were purchased by support Seb. But Ryu is really not impacting the game the way Typical Mistakes really need him to.
Dendi style.
Exactly, Dendi style, or even Arteezy style at this point. although Arteezy is just a monster on Storm Spirit.
Yeah, Arteezy is the kind of guy I hear so much about him, but I don't get a chance to cast him very often. So he's also very young, right? Isn't he like 16, 17?
He just graduated from high school.
Okay.
Like a month ago, like a couple weeks ago. So Yeah, nah, he's really young too. He actually had a lot of problems trying to go to attending some tournaments because he was still attending high school, so he wasn't really able to participate in all the online events.
Mm-hmm. No, that's understandable. Oh man, Slizer finding a good angle. Oh, he gets a stun just on one hero though. Crit looking for that perfect shackle. Gets it too. Two heroes getting shackled to each other. Crit, this might turn around the teamfight. Nyx Prophet still drops nonetheless. Big ball lightning in by Ryu. Disabling Hestage, he gets up the refraction, tries to survive now. Crit also low, another stun being thrown by Slizel. What a fight by Typical Mistakes. Shackle doesn't latch, Link in trouble now as well. The Soul Assumption doesn't do a whole lot of work, but look at Typical Mistakes, the damage spread, so beautiful. And they lose, they get two kills from eL'Pride, and they're able to back out in peace now.
Yeah, it's looking like eL'Pride are just lacking some serious focus fire issues, because we're seeing like four heroes walk away.
Yeah.
With 500, 200 hell, and that's a focus fire issue. That's nothing but a focus fire issue. So,
That's the kind of thing that that's, you know, when you have like your group of friends that you play Dota with all the time, this is like the number one problem. You know, you hit a certain skill level, and then you have team fights, and most of the time, the number one issue why you lose team fights is because the communication is not on that level where you really focus the same guy the whole time. At least that's my experience. I can totally understand where eL'Pride's coming from right now, but granted, this is something that shouldn't happen at this kind of level of play. So eL'Pride making a little bit of perhaps, I don't know if it was maybe a issue of communication, maybe they didn't make clear focus targets, or the initiation and the fight from Typical Mistakes just didn't give them another option. I mean, Sanking stuns in, goes for a sandstorm, all of a sudden he is out of the picture, but they were able to focus him a little bit, so they were forced to switch targets to maybe a Storm Spear to Ball Lightning, then the Ball Lightning backed out again. So all in all, maybe a combination of the two, but one thing that is for certain is that Typical Mistakes played that fight extremely well.
They absolutely did, but big problem, eL'Pride is getting some big items out. Noya just finished his mech, and Link just finished his BKB. So that's going to make the next fight a lot harder for Typical Mistakes, because we're not seeing any big items coming out of TM. Like, Lifestealer has this Armlet, which is huge for Lifestealer, don't get me wrong, but it's not going to be as effective in teamfights like a mech or a BKB.
Definitely. Yeah, that's true. So eL'Pride, they kind of have the possibility right now to simply, kind of just go in and take, like, towers and you know, not care about the enemy team, you know, on the back of a mech and a BKB. They can just fight and man up, and they can't do anything about that. So Typical Mistakes, they need those teamfight items. Shackle! Oh. Latched onto Lone Druid, a huge jump by Storm Spirit. He has a Nakes infested in there as well. Noya forced to use the mech, but he's getting focused down as well. Will the damage be there? What a good frostbite by Mini. Storm Spirit in a huge trouble as well. It's a one for one so far. Cakes went down on one side, Noya on the other side. What a stun by Slizel! He's gonna get that epicenter out as well. Mini surviving this. I have no idea how. Crit running away as well. And they focus down to Sand King. I have no clue as to how eL'Pride managed to turn this around in the way they did.
That was really impressive team fighting from eL'Pride. That was like, last fight we had focus fire issues. This other team still like, Typical Mistakes had the same focus fire issues. They wanted to go on Link, but Link was BKB'd, so there was just nothing going on there. And by the time that Slizel managed to get off his epicenter, most of the Typical Mistakes damage deal was already dead. Lifestealer was gone, Ryu was out of mana, and then Cakes was dead. Although, really clever play from Ryu. Oh, is he gonna get crit?
Oh, crit might be in trouble. Shackle, oh, my goodness, that tree. That tree was growing for 25 years just for this moment. And down goes Storm Spirit.
Yeah, that was... I'm sure Ryu's just thinking to himself, Jesus, those shackles. It's like every time we play against a winner, it's always, they're hacking. They get these shackles like nobody's business.
Yeah, that was pretty ridiculous.
But I do think Typical Mistakes, even though they were able to win that one team fight in mid, I don't think that was indicative of a huge change. It seemed more like eL'Pride wasn't really on the ball for that fight, but definitely they are now, especially with the advantage that they eked out by having a stronger laning phase.
Yeah, here's the story of the game. I mean, if we look at the gold graph, it's been steadily rising. And if we look at the experience graph, there's a big dip down where Typical Mistakes was winning that fight. But after that fight happened, at that point in time, like 50 minutes in, we switch over to the gold graph, it's still like 6k in favor of eL'Pride. So all the items, all that item difference was what in the end led to that huge swing over in experience when that last fight happened. eL'Pride not only had the better focus fire, maybe the better team fight mechanics, but also the mech, the BKB on the right hero, and the damage output required to just completely destroy Typical Mistakes there. So I agree, I mean, Typical Mistakes, they had a great team fight up on top, but they need more of that. And right now, eL'Pride just continuing where they let off. They left
off
earlier.
The big problem though is it comes down to the gold, and Typical Mistakes are just too far behind in terms of gold. Yeah, they just felt too familiar as well.
Four staff on Windrunner as well, so these are those items coming up right now. TA, she's going for Sanjin Yasha by the looks of it.
I really hope not a Sanjin Yasha. I really hope that's a Yasha and a BKB.
Oh, Ryu! Ah, oh, that Nagus bomb! Down goes crit, ulted by Mini from a very great position. Phanosoyan, though, under the cover of Rage, not for long anymore, though. And his three heroes down, buyback used by Nagus. Typical Mistakes, Ryu, healing up in base. And crit also bought back. A tier 3 is gonna go down, does not get denied. Phanosoyan needs to rage out and get out. And yeah, thanks for pointing that out. Oh, there's that ball lightning in. Hestijo, too tanky. Refraction just doing too much work right there, and that's gonna be the... And that's what I was talking about. That item advantage gives eL'Pride the ability to walk in, take high ground, and be like, okay, we're gonna take your racks, and you cannot do anything about it.
And one of the big things is with the BKB, Typical Mistakes damage output at this point is non-existent. It's just Lifestealer doesn't have the items he needs. With the armor on, he hits for maybe 170 damage, which is good. 170 damage is solid, especially with 3 points in Feast. But this is compared to the team fighting damage that's coming out of Gyrocopter, which is also 170 damage, but to everybody.
Mm.
And Templar Assassin, which is more than 170 damage to a couple of people, but armor reduction. So it's really... Typical Mistakes just don't have the physical damage output now that the BKB is up on Link.
Yeah, it just doesn't compare to eL'Pride.
Yeah, four it does staff. Look like Hesed Joe's going for a BKB, though.
Yeah, I hope so too. I just, you know, I see a Yasha, I see an Ogre Club, and I think, Sanji Yasha, man, I got this shit figured out.
You got this shit figured out? It's like he's playing Race Car Lifestealer.
Yeah. Well, maybe that's a new thing, man. Who knows?
Race
Do
Car
you
Life
know?
It was like a thing a month ago, and then it kind of vanished. I don't know what happened to Race Car Lifestealer. I miss it.
I saw him yesterday.
Saw him yesterday? That's
yeah,
awesome.
in the D2L match. Man.
Oh man, I wish he just gets picked off. This is gonna be another rack. I don't think there's anything Typical Mistakes can do to defend this.
I don't know, man. They can fake GG.
Well, that's Russian GG. Do you want to be associated with that?
I don't know. I mean,
I don't know. I think that was like an M5 strat, wasn't it?
There's like 2k on the line, man. I wouldn't. I would freaking do that.
you would do an M5 GG
for 2k? I don't know. There's some people that do stuff like that for $322. Oh, there's that team fight going on. What a stun by the guy in pink, but he drops. Nakes also dead. BKB Link is just too strong.
Oh,
four
God.
Heroes down. That power shot cleans up everything. And that is game for eL'Pride.
Also, that 322, Joe. I feel like that's a bit overdone by now.
No.
No, you gotta make more of those.
No, the thing is, I never make jokes about that. There's people that make pictures, they put that number into their names. I have never made a 322 joke just now because I thought it was applicable. But the thing is, because other people overdo it, I have to pay the price, and I don't think that is warranted. So I just do it.
Don't worry, our Twitch chat will now be filled with those images.
I don't know, my chat isn't working, unfortunately.
Actually, no one's chat's really working. It's like, you can see some of them pop up, but you can't really talk to each other because of Twitch issues.
Yeah. Twitch issues. There's that Ancient dropping. No more 322 jokes from me. That was the first and last you're ever going to hear from me. You guys better stop as well, because it does get annoying. But it was very applicable. Now, eL'Pride, they move on. Typical Mistakes are out, and... Well, I would love to see more of Typical Mistakes in the future, but for now, eL'Pride just the stronger team today. It was a very fun game to watch. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. We're going to be back in a few minutes with the quarterfinal of the Big Point Battle. Not sure exactly which one that's going to be. I'm going to let you guys know in just a few minutes. And yeah, until then, guys, eL'Prez, thanks for coming on.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
How did you like this game?
I would like to point the irony in that.
Sorry?
Crystal Maiden is one of two people who didn't die at all this game.
Yeah, Mini, he's just redefining what it means to be a Crystal Maiden.
Can't melt.
Yeah, it was...
Definitely cool under pressure. Okay, that's enough ice jokes.
Okay. Anything else you wanna say before we head ourselves into the next game?
I'm definitely looking forward to the next game. eL'Pride definitely looking very strong right now, especially with Mini as their new captain. Definitely some interesting drafts, and I wasn't sure about the Crystal Maiden really working out here, but Mini definitely showing off his skills as an individual player as well.
He made it work, my friends. Next game, coming up in a few minutes. See you then.